Hello everyone, welcome to Quantifiers again. So today we are going to discuss a DI set that is called the pyramid. Anyway, before we move to the set, like always, just few more days to go. Please keep doing these three activities. Keep solving your practice threads. Keep revising the sets from the DILR book, which is basically the PDF of all the sets we do on our YouTube. And then please keep doing these learnish mocks. This will really help you in the long run. Right, keep doing those. Then, okay, let's see what today's set is all about. It says, a number pyramid is defined as a pyramidal shape formed using the numbers, such as the top row consists of one number, the second row, this is the second row that consists two numbers, the third row consists of three numbers, the fourth is of fourth numbers, and so on. Okay. Lakshya, a curious student, decides to make a number pyramid using all the numbers in the base 15, which means the numbers allowed are 0 to 14, right? These are the 15 numbers allowed. Now, 10 is represented by A, 11 is represented by B, which is basically the common notation by which we represent our numbers in the base higher than 10, right? And then there are conditions. So, okay, let's read it out and let's keep writing whatever is given to us. Right, so how many places are there first of all? First of all, there are 5 rows, which means 15 places, 15 places, which means 5 rows, right? So 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. These are the 15 places, right? For number 15 numbers, 0 to 14. Okay, now the numbers allowed are 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, and 14. Why I have written all the numbers? Because as I will fill these numbers, I will negate it from here. It will be easy for me to identify the leftovers. Right? Okay. Now, first things first, sabse pehle wo kya kehte hai? The sum of the apex. Apex is the topmost value. The rightmost numbers of every row is equal to 38, which means the sum of these, this is equal to 38. The sum of apex and leftmost values is also 38. And the same is true for it. The sum of all the numbers is fifth row is also 38. So this is also 38. So these three rows will sum up to 38. I'll remember that, right? So this point is taken care of. The sum is going to be 38 for this row, and this row, last row, right? Okay, fine then. The number of three vertices, the number at the three vertices of the pyramid forms a Pythagorean triplet. So there are Pythagorean triplet is being formed. So how can I form Pythagorean triplet? The basic is 3, 4, 5. So 3, 4, 5 is possible. Second basic is 5, 12, and 13. Right. The modification being, isko agar 2 se multiply karunga to aayega 6, 8, and 10. 3 se karunga to aayega 9, 12, 15. Allowed nahi hai because of 10 is not allowed. So either it could be 3, 4, 5. Either it could be 6, 8, 10. Either it could be 5, 12, 13. The numbers which will come on the corners, on the vertices, right? Okay. Okay, then. the sum of the numbers in the second row is 27. So these two sum up to 27. Okay, there is only one possibility, that is 14 plus 13. Now it is 14, 13 or 13, 14, right? Something like this. The difference of apex digit with the leftmost digit and the rightmost number in second row is 11 and 10. So difference of this number, let's say this is A, this is B, this is C. Then B minus A is 11 and C minus A is 10, right? A being same, which means there is a difference of 1 between B and C. That I already know, 14 and 13. And since the difference, this is higher, which means this value will be higher. So here we have 14 and here we have 13. Because we have the difference hai, wo in dono numbers ka zyada hai in dono se. So here the value aegi, wo ek zyada aegi. So how much is apne paas? 14 hai. Okay, so this is 14, this is 13, right? And this is obviously 3 because 14 minus 3 11 and 13 minus 3 10, right? So if this is 3, this is 4 and this is 5, right? So even a sort ho gaya. Now 3 is gone, 4 is gone, 5 is gone, 13 is gone, 14 is gone, right? These 5 numbers have already been placed, right? Okay. Okay. Now let's leave this condition. The sum of numbers in the fourth row is half of the sum of the numbers in the fifth row. So this is 19. Right, the sum of this is 19. Moreover, the sum here was 38. Right, the sum here was 38. So 4, 14 and 3, 17 and 4, 21 is the sum here. So which means these two values will add up to 17. Similarly, 3 and 13, 16 and 5, 21. These two values will also sum up to 17. Right? Okay, done. The difference between the number placed at the third row, at the end and the rightmost place, third row and the fourth row is 5. So difference between these two numbers is 5, this place and this place. And I know the sum is 12. So A minus B, basically the sum of difference of 2 is 5. The sum of 2 is 17. Though I could have directly said that if I take 5 out, I'm left with 12, with 12 and the difference would be 6 and 11. The numbers would be 6 and 11. Do possibilities aayengi, 6, 11, ya fir 11, 6, right? And I will again repeat ki maine kya kaha ki mujhe pata tha ki difference 5 hone wala hai. So agar main difference hata do to baki do number barabar batenge. So 17 mein se if I remove the difference, that is 12, do number barabar aayenge 6, 6 and difference goes back to one number, that is 11. This is how you quickly solve the equations. Right. Okay. So this is 6 and this is 11. One of them is 6 and one of them is 11. Right. Okay. So 6, 11, 11 and 6. Right. Okay. Okay. This is also taken care of. The difference between the number plate at placed at the leftmost place in the fourth row and that of fifth row is 6. So their difference is 6. Now this cannot, this definitely cannot be minus 2. So this must be 10. Now if this is 10 and the sum is 17, quite easy, this is 10 and this is 7, then, right? Okay. Now I have to make this sum 19, right? If I have to make the sum of this row 19, I cannot give this 10 and give this 11, right? Because in dono ka sum 11 ban jayega, uske 21 ban jayega, to ye 6 aayega aur ye 11 aayega. This is 6 and this is 11. Now 10 and 6, 16. So leftover is 3. 3 can only be attained by 1, 2 and 2, 1. So 1 or 2. 2 or 1, right? Ab apne paas aur kya kya chala gaya? 7 is gone, 11 is gone, 13, 14 already gone, 1 gone, 2 gone, 4, 5 is done, 3 is done. So these are the leftover number 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and 6. Okay, 1, 2, 3. Okay, okay, okay. So there is one or more number that has gone. Okay, let's see. Now, I have to make this sum. I have to make this sum. 38, right? This is one hint that is left with me. I have to make this sum 38. Now, what value I can use here to make the sum 38, right? So, okay, 10 is already gone. 10 is also gone. So number left are, let the number left with me are 0, 8, 9 and 12. I have to make these three sums 29. 5, 4, 9. I have to make this 29. And that is 12, 9, 8. 12 and 9, 21 and 8, 29. Quite visible. Out of these four, I will pick these three. So these three can come in any order. So 8, 9, 12, yahan pe bhi aa sakta hai, in may be 8, 9, 12, in may be 8, 9, 12. So number left is 0, which will be placed here. So I can identify all other places except these 5, right? Out of 15, I have identified 10 places and I'm left with 5 places. I don't know how they can be arranged. So nothing else can be done. Let's move to the question. How many such number pyramids are possible? How many numbers are pyramid possible? So in these row, these three elements are not fixed. These three elements can be adjusted in 3 factorial or 6 ways. These two elements can be arranged in 2 factorial or 2 ways. So the net arrangements are 6 into 2, 12. So 3 factorial 6, 2 factorial 2, the total 6 into 2, 12. 12 combinations are possible. Okay, done. Which number will appear at leftmost place in 4th row? Leftmost 4th row, 10. 10 is nothing but A. Please keep in mind that here you will write A because 10 A is 10, B is 11, C is 12, D is 13, E is 14. Right. So keep this thing in mind. Okay. So this is A. This is B. Right. Okay. So I'll just use it whenever required. What can be the maximum possible sum of the numbers placed at the rightmost place in the third row? In the third row, rightmost place, this was B. B was 11. So this is 11 fixed. Plus the second number from left in the fifth row. Fifth row, second number from the left. That is this. So it can be 12 at max. So the maximum sum possible is 23. In base 10, it will be 23 only. Right. So 23 is the required answer. Last question. Third row. Next question. Third. Okay. Third row and the second. Okay, so this is just the repeat statement. Okay, just a repeat statement. digits for how many places can be uniquely determined? These are 10 places, right? We have already determined out of 15, 5 are gone. So these are 10 places. Now see, this set was really very easy, but sometime what we do, we puzzle up in the combinations required and everything, but please make sure that whatever data is given to you, fit that data first and then move to the various combinations possible. Right. I hope you have enjoyed the video. If you have enjoyed, please do subscribe to our channel. Thank you so much, guys. Have a great day.